So, as I was talking, this painting is going to be Doctor Strange from Infinity War. And I know I'm dressed up like Annie Hall because, well, Annie Hall, right? But, alright, so what I wanted to talk about this, I know I haven't been on for a while, there's been a lot of stuff happening. I figured I'd get back on there, and I know there's some people on the guard to bother the shit out of me, but whatever. People suck. Not do this. But anyway. So, Doctor Strange Infinity War, there's a scene where he is like, he's looking into the future with the time stone gem or whatever and seeing all the possible outcomes of, you know, the fight. And so, like, the last, I'd say, like, 3 or 4 years, I've been waking up with some severe anxiety. And it's, you know, it's that unconscious period where just before you wake up, it's kind of like the doctor's going to go through all these permutations, and it's like, you know, he's just like, his head is spinning, and that's how I wake up, and that sucks. But, you know, dealing with it, through therapy and medication, so it's been done. Still there. Stages, but I get to paint again, so that's fine. So what I really wanted to talk about was, what I really want to talk about more is like just the beginning processes of how I paint and what painting is. For me, it's like I just write scribbly-dobbly on the just to start it off. Although I might do an Annie Hall painting, I'm not sure. I don't know, is the reception on that film still okay or not? I don't know, I don't remember. But anyway, that's a great film. I was watching this Ken Burns documentary on Manhattan. I really like Manhattan. I've always liked it. Living next to Manhattan, it's always been like, it's always been like this cultural epicenter, you know, and like just going there and looking at people watching and just experiencing everything Manhattan has to offer. It's, I don't know. Yeah, growing up in a small town in Jersey, like, you know, that was the one place you went to in high school. You know, you always traveled there. And I've, you know, had many jobs there, and done many things, and it's a significant marker for me. I live in Los Angeles, but, you know, LA is, it's cool, but it's not like that. But, alright, so the Doctor Strange, and again, when I start my paintings, it's just gobbledygook. Like, it's just a whole bunch of thoughts until I want to figure out. This is a great 48x60 canvas, and I start out with like, dioxazine purple. But for the most part, like, I kind of block in where I want my main center of attention to be. Usually it's composition, but this is a pretty straightforward piece. It's just kind of like a direct on. So it's not going to be like where you have to worry too much about composition. Composition does play a big part of it. But I think from that aspect, I'm just roughing this stuff. So, I know he makes but his head like goes in several different ways. So what I'm looking at doing here is, you know, he's seated in his they're doing that, like, you know, the heavy metal thing. So I guess that's like witchcraft. Is that witchcraft heavy metal? Are we doing witchcraft songs? Is that the heavy metal as well? Witchcraft. But I've always really called the character of Doctor Strange. Actually, it's more Doctor Strange. I forgot what one of Doctor Strange it was, but I think it was like the 60s where it got really psychedelic, and they did a really good job on that. On the first Doctor Strange, by kind of like showing that part to really like. So, and again, maybe I'll do it again. This changes a lot. Like, you know, when I start, like, I'm not too crazy about it. But, you know, I might shift things around later. I don't know if you could talk to me. Can you tell what's happening here? Or, I don't pay attention to comments or anybody's talking, so I won't. Maybe I'll extend this course a little bit more. At the early stages, it's so much fun. I'm still waiting for my headset stuff to come out. Those headsets and stuff. And, like, I listen to music a lot when I'm painting, so there's like this thing, it's called Rooger. I don't know if you've heard of it, but it's like, it's supposed to, like, you know, give you haptic feedback, whatever haptic means. It basically just amplifies the bass beats, which I'm really looking forward to, because, you know, I still love dubstep, so. We'll get working on this, but I just wanted to give you guys an update on, like, you know, where I'm at, what I'm doing, so I really want to incorporate, like, the psychedelic background on this, but I just want to give you a heads up. I'm not dead. I haven't died. But, you know, it has been difficult, kind of working through all this, and I'm slowly getting back to it, so I'm slowly getting back to painting. And I'm completing a lot more paintings. So this will probably be in progress. For those of you who have my paintings, and for those of you who wanted some of my paintings, it's been years since. It takes time. But, you know, lately I've been more dedicated on this. So I've been getting that stuff done a lot faster. But yeah, I just kind of want to give you guys a heads up as to, you know, what I'm doing, what's going on. I am, like, breaking out of the whole hermit lifestyle, so I've become a little bit more social and trying to get back out of that. Again, it's all about what's going on in the cabeza. So, yeah, that's where we're at right now, and I don't know if you can see that, but, all right, so I'll probably post more updates as time goes by. We'll see. But yeah, and again, if anybody really wants an Annie Hall themed painting, I really want to do something about Manhattan. Again, that Ken Burns special about Manhattan was like, you know, I didn't realize how fortunate I was growing up so close to Manhattan and just being exposed to it, that I think it jades me in a lot of ways, to people that, or ideas, or whatever, that don't fall into that bracket. So. Well, I'm happy to be back, and all right, we'll leave that for now. All right, catch you guys later.